Even though Ornellis occurs there and has a range of the Cambrian, that tells you, well, this has to be...
This video illustrates one way of running a 50-minute group-based active lesson for large classes. You will see one instructor and two teaching assistants, so that there is roughly 1-to-50 ratio of experts to students. These students completed one 50-minute hands-on exercise the previous week with subsequent homework. It is the fourth such exercise this term, so students know what to expect. They quickly form ad hoc groups of four, and worksheets are handed out as they arrive. Then only 4 more minutes are needed to introduce objectives and highlight how time should be allocated to tasks.
I've broken it down into the amount of time which you should be maybe spending on each task in order such that you can get through it.
A projector helps with this introduction. Also, some figures are on the chalkboard and others are available to project if clarifying is needed. Students have already started, so a microphone is advised and the instructor talks as little as possible. Try to prevent groups from sitting 4 in a row. Groups with 2 facing 2 work best because they can share ideas and materials. Notice that when tasks are interesting, there is a buzz of intellectual activity that is satisfying for instructors to see. Running a class this way represents a scaling up of tutoring. Groups are noisy and work is visible. Instructing involves both seeing and hearing students' thinking and then reacting to it. Expertise is provided to individuals, groups, or the whole class exactly where it's needed.
All you really need to do is work out what a proportion of 540...
The instructor's work involves preparing a meaningful, appropriately challenging exercise rather than developing long, story-like lectures. Notice how virtually all these third-year students are fully engaged. The teaching team distribute expertise to as many groups as possible. This classroom has both tablet seating and narrow desks, so you can see that any room configaration can work. While circulating, short, friendly prompts will solicit questions. A wireless microphone makes it easier to interrupt when common issues can be addressed to the whole class.
And then work out proportionally where those divisions should occur.
This teaching assistant is referring to figures projected or sketched on the board to help with tutoring. Use the same tutoring practices that work for one-on-one teaching. Ask questions of students. Have them wrestle with concepts by guiding the thinking. Offer explanations sparingly, only when necessary.
Now, if you look at figure 2, you see that all the geological periods are all equal size.
Keeping up the pace is one of the challenges. Everyone works at different speeds. Use a microphone and emphasize the purpose and principal challenge. Even if many don't listen, it helps to keep the exercise moving forward. Exercises involve a variety of tasks, including sketching, calculating, measuring, ranking, choosing, referring to homework or the text, and so on. There are many approaches to logistics. We give one worksheet for each group's work and provide questions only on separate sheets for each student. Students tell us that they like having one of these exercises each week, and they recognize the benefits of learning this way. What do you see as benefits of these Friday activities?
Yeah, I like the interacting with the prof, whereas in a class setting I would never be able to do this.
I find the TAs very helpful, actually, and I talk to them about everything I need help with. You know, they're always very helpful.
Do you like these activity days?
It's kind of nice to be, like, do something different from all the lecture stuff because, like, it gets you talking with other people. So I actually kind of find it enjoyable.
Does this group work help you do well in this course?
Yeah, actually, because I don't really like to review after my classes. So, like, this kind of forces me to, like, review and then be, like, to contribute in group activities. So it actually kind of gets me to review stuff. You're actually talking with group members, like talking about what you need to learn, what you need to know.
These two videos have illustrated a hands-on plus follow-up sequence which engages a large class of science students by having groups think together about real challenges with adequate opportunities to interact with experts.